In this video, we will be taking a look at powers and roots for GCSE 9-1 maths for the AQAE specification, EdXL specification, OCR specification, WGEC, okay, and it's aimed around the foundation tier for level 3-4, so grade 3-4 maths, and I got it from the Maths Made Easy website.co.uk. Okay, and we're looking at powers and roots. Okay, so no calculators can be used for this video. Okay, this is question number 1A. Simplify a squared times a to the 4. Well, when I multiply with the same base, so a is my base, I just add the powers. So 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. So it's a to the power of 6. Okay. Part B, simplify b to the 6 divided by b cubed. When I divide, I just subtract the powers, provided that it's the same base. So this only applies if I'm multiplying and dividing with the same base. Okay, so when I'm multiplying with the same base, I add the powers, and when I'm dividing, I subtract the powers. 6 take away 3 is 3. So it's b to the power of 3. This is part C. Work out 4 times 2 to the power of 3. Well, 2 to the power of 3 just means 2 times 2 times 2. Okay, so 2 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 8. Okay, 2 times 2 is 4. Times 2 again is 8. 4 times 8 is 32. Okay, that's my answer for part C. This is question number 2A. Simplify m to the 7 times m to the 4. Well, I'm just going to simply add my powers. So 7 add 4 is equal to 11. Okay, so it's m to the 11. So remember, guys, just to be clear, it's got to be the same base, so it's got to be the same letter and or number for me to add my powers if I'm multiplying. For part B, simplify m to the power of 7 divided by m to the 4. Okay, so I'm going to subtract the powers. 7 take away 4 is equal to 3. So it's m to the power of 3. This is part C, guys. Work out 3 to the power of 0. Well, anything to the power of 0 in maths is just 1. Okay, anything to the power of 0 is just 1. Okay, this is question 3A. Simplify n to the 7 times n. Remember that I've got an invisible 1 here. So I'm going to have n to the 7 plus 1, which is equal to 8. So it's n to the power of 8. Okay. This is part B. Simplify p to the power of 6 divided by p to the 5. Well, subtracting my powers, 6 take away 5 is equal to 1. Okay, so it's p to the power of 1, or just p. Okay. This is part C now. Simplify 2q to the 4 or to the 5. Well, that's going to be 2q to the 4 times 2q to the 4 times 2q to the 4. To the 4 times 2q to the 4. Times 2q to the 4. Okay, so anything to the power of 5 means that it's multiplied by itself 5 times. So 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. And 16 times 2 is 32. Okay, I'm not sure why I've put a q to the 5 there. It should be q to the 4. Sorry. Okay. And I've got q to the 4. And so q to the 4 times 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 q to the 4. Well, that's going to be just adding the powers. 4 add 4 add 4 add 4 add 4 is going to be 20. So 32 q to the 20. This is question number 4a. Simplify 3n squared all cubed. Well, that's 3n squared times 3n squared times 3n squared. Okay, so 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. N squared times n squared times n squared is just n to the power of 6. Okay, this is part B. Simplify ag to the 7 or to the 14. So I've got an a to the power of 1 there. I've got a to the 1 to the power of 14. So it's going to be a to the 14. Okay. Because 1 times 14 is 14. And I'm going to have g to the 7 times 14. So whenever we have a number or letter raised to a power and then to a bracket, another power, we essentially multiply the powers. So a to the 1 times 14 is just going to be a to the 14. Okay, so it's going to be a to the 14, g to the 14. It should be a g there, guys, I apologize. So 14 times 7, well, 7 times 4 is 28, 7 times 10 is 70, adding it, I get 98, okay? So that's that one there, guys, okay? This is question number 5a. Simplify 9t to the 4 all squared. Well, it's 9t to the 4 times 9t to the 4. So 9 times 9 is 81. T to the 4 times T to the 4 is T to the 8. Okay, so remember that when I multiply, the bases are the same. I just add the powers. 4 plus 4 is 8. Part B, simplify 24x to the 4, y to the 10, divided by 6x squared, y to the 7. 24 divided by 6 is 4. X to the 4 divided by x squared is 4 minus 2, which is 2. Y to the 10 divided by y to the 7 is just y to the power of 3. Okay, so it's 4x squared y cubed. Okay, this is question number 6a. Simplify 7a squared b cubed times 8a to the 4 b to the 6. 7 times 8 is 56. A squared times a to the 4 is a to the power of 6. B cubed times b to the 6 is b to the power of 9. Okay. Part B, simplify this. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. A to the 4 divided by a squared is going to be a to the power of 2, because 4 take away 2 is 2. B to the power of 6 divided by b to the power of 3 is 6 take away 3, which is 3. Okay, for part C, simplify 2ab all squared times 2a to the 4b to the 6. Okay. So 2 squared is 4ab all squared. It's going to be a squared b squared. So So 4 times 2 is 8. A squared times 8 to the 4 is A to the 6. B squared times B to the 6 is going to be B to the 8. Okay, because 2 plus 6 is 8. And 2 plus 4 is 6 for the power of 8. And 4 lots of 2, or 4 times 2, is 8. Okay? Right, guys, so that concludes today's video. So I hope you found it useful. I hope you found it informative. If you did, please press like. Please subscribe to the channel if you're new. Okay, and also turn on post notification by clicking that little bell icon next to the big red button that says subscribe. Okay, and lastly, please share my videos and tell your friends and family and anyone that might benefit from extra support with their GCC maths, Key Stage 3 maths, Key Stage 2 maths, Key Stage 1 maths, A-level pure maths, and A-level further pure maths. Okay, but that's it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Abdallah Wahishi, and I'm your Key Stage 3 and GCC 9 to 1 maths tutor, and I do also offer private tuition, so please get in touch with me if you want some private tuition, okay, for maths. Okay, but that's it for me today, guys. Thanks for watching. Take care, stay safe. Okay, enjoy your Christmas, and I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye for now.